What's up, everybody? This is Michael Hall, and today I'm going to be walking you through how to set up a website. If you are a filmmaker, a freelancer, or an artist, having a website is essential. And I know personally, I waited a really long time to set up a website because the process seemed really intimidating, and I wish that someone would have just sat down and explained the whole process to me. And so that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to sit here and show you step by step how to get everything done quickly and effectively. Honestly, I think we can be done in like 15 minutes. So let's do it. Let's get started. If you are on my blog or you're watching this on YouTube, there is going to be a link right below, and that's going to take you to a website called Bluehost.com. Bluehost is a hosting service. If you're not familiar with the term hosting, it's essentially a service that you're paying to rent space on the internet. So Bluehost has a really good offer. They start their plans at $349 a month, which is really good. You do have to pay, I believe it's 36 months up front if you go with the $349 a month offer. But that's what I always do. I think it's a really good deal. They have really good customer support. I don't know. I've never really had an issue with them. I think they're great. There's a lot of hosting providers out there, but for this tutorial, I'm going to use Bluehost. So, okay, if you click through on those links, you're going to land on a page that looks pretty much like this. I'm sure that they will have updated since I recorded this video, but somewhere on the page, I guarantee you're going to find a big Get Started Now button. All you have to do is click that, and it's going to take you through to the plan options. As I said, I like $349 a month, so I'm going to click through with that. That's going to take you to the domain setup. If you have a domain name that you have in mind, you can check it here on the left. For this example, I'm just going to use a variation of my name. Let's try Michael. See if that's available. Now, if it is available, it's going to say congratulations. You're ready to get set up, which this looks like it's available, which is great. If it's not available, it'll just kick you back and say basically pick another domain name. This is where we're going to put in all our account information. So billing address, name, phone number, email address. Second. Okay, now we're looking at package information. I do not like the Site Backup Pro. I don't think it's necessary. I don't like the Site Lock domain security. I don't think that's necessary. I like to keep the domain privacy protection. I think that is worth it. Essentially, what that means is every time you purchase a domain, that can be public record. But if you pay 83 cents per month to Bluehost, they will keep your information private. So I like to do that. I think that is worth the 83 cents a month. Now scroll down to the bottom. This is where you're going to put in your billing information and your credit card number. So 1 second. All right. Okay, at the bottom, just confirm that you've read and agree to terms of service, cancellation policy, privacy, domain. Okay, that all looks good. So click next. Okay, so next page is gonna take you to, looks like they're gonna try and sell you a couple things here. I'm gonna tell you right now that you don't need any of this additional stuff. So just scroll down to the bottom and make sure your additional upgrade total says $0. And click complete. Okay, that's gonna take you to a congratulations page. This is just telling you that they're sending a confirmation to your email address. So now we need to create a new password for Bluehost. They want you to create a really difficult password, so I just like to use the password generator. So click password generator and just copy down the password that they have created for you and paste that into the box. Now I have a spreadsheet open. I'm gonna paste my password here just so I remember it. Click back. Click confirm and create. Okay, so now we are going to log in to our new Bluehost account. Make sure that in the top box is your domain name that you just purchased, and now paste the password that you just created. Click submit. All right, it's going to now, it looks like they wanted to sell you something else. Just say no thank you. And now we're in the back end of our Bluehost page. Click out of that. And now we can scroll down to the website section. And that's where we can install WordPress. It's very easy, just click install WordPress. And give it a second. Alrighty. Now click install. So WordPress is going to want you to check and make sure that you own the domain. We know that we own the domain because we just purchased it through Bluehost, but WordPress just wants to double check. Okay, click that you've read terms and conditions and install. It's going to take a moment to install. Once it's done installing, you'll notice up at the top there's going to be a progress bar. Click out of this really quick. So the progress bar up at the top says your install is underway. It's just going to take a couple seconds. And it'll turn orange once the installation is complete. You'll notice down below they're going to try and sell you a bunch of themes and templates. You do not need to purchase any of those at the moment. Now click View Credentials. So your credentials are basically what will log you into the back end of your WordPress. You'll notice that there's a note that says the information will be deleted after 12 hours. So we want to copy down these credentials. You're going to scroll down a little bit. So you see there a username and password. Like I said, we want to copy these down into our spreadsheet that we have open. paste them here. I'm just gonna copy my password. The username is just the email address you signed up with. And now you can access the back end of your WordPress by clicking the admin URL. You might want to copy down the admin URL as well in the spreadsheet that you have open, just so you remember it. All the admin URL really is the domain name that you just purchased, /wp/admin. And that'll take you to your username and password. That's where you'll put it in. So like I said, username is just the email address you use to purchase domain with. Let's add that in there. And paste the password. Click login, and that is going to take you to the dashboard of your WordPress site. This is essentially where you will control everything for the appearance of your site. Scroll down to appearance and click themes. This is where we're going to install a theme for the site. These are all free themes. I'm gonna click this 2014 theme and activate it just so you can see what it looks like. Okay, so now it's active on my domain. If we were to go to my domain that I just purchased right now, it would look exactly like that. But let me edit a post really quick just so you can see that I'm actually controlling this. All right, now click edit and dismiss that. I'm just gonna change this really quick. Say, hey y'all, exclamation points. And take that sucker out of there. What's up? All right, click update. And now if we go to the domain I just purchased, you will see that updated the domain with the theme and my text. Hey y'all, what's up? So guys, there you go. That is pretty much it. I hope you can see how easy this entire process is. Like I said, no HTML, no crazy coding or anything like that. It's incredibly easy to get a project up online quickly, efficiently. If you have a project or just a personal profile, using Bluehost and WordPress is the best way to go. Thanks so much for watching. If you have any questions, be sure to leave them in the comments of this video, or if you're on my blog, you can leave them below. Thanks so much.